In every chosen person's life, there are certain individuals you must be vigilant about, no matter your circumstances. As someone marked by destiny, encountering these types of people is almost a certainty, either by coincidence or by fate. The first group you'll encounter I call the Judas group. These individuals are essentially frenemies. They befriend you only to betray you later. You might feel a certain closeness or fondness for them, which they exploit to their advantage. Although it may be relatively straightforward to spot their deceit, the real challenge lies in our willingness to overlook the warning signs they display. These are the people who jeopardize destinies. While some individuals are meant to help us achieve our purposes, others only stick around during our low moments. As soon as you begin to recover and ascend towards fulfilling your potential, their true feelings surface. They loathe seeing you succeed and will do anything in their power to prevent any positivity or success from unfolding in your life. Recognizing the true nature of those around you is crucial, especially when you start to step into your own greatness or manifest the greatness that God has instilled within you. At such moments, the real sentiments of those you've known, friends, colleagues, or even family, can begin to surface, revealing that their issues aren't necessarily with you as a person, but with the potential and divine gifts that you carry. This realization is essential as these individuals can become significant obstacles to your growth and success due to their inability to see you succeed. The danger these individuals pose is profound because their discomfort with your success may lead them to act in ways that could undermine or hurt you. A clear indicator of such individuals is their choice of associates. It's a significant warning sign if someone who calls themselves your friend also maintains close ties with those who oppose you or wish you harm. This concept isn't just theoretical, but is grounded in historical and biblical contexts, as illustrated by the story of Judas in the Bible. Judas, one of Jesus' own disciples, is a poignant example of someone who, despite being part of Jesus' inner circle, ultimately betrayed him. His betrayal was not just a personal betrayal, but a reflection of deeper issues with Jesus' mission and teachings. Thus, being wary of those who associate with your detractors is not about suspicion, but about wise caution. Observing these associations helps you protect your path and purpose from those who may not genuinely wish you well. Household enemies represent a unique and deeply personal challenge on one's spiritual journey. These adversaries aren't distant strangers. They are often the very people who sit at our dinner tables, our siblings, parents, or extended family. It's an unsettling reality that those within our own homes can sometimes pose the greatest threat to our spiritual growth and destiny. In the biblical narrative of Joseph, we find a poignant example of this type of challenge. Joseph's journey to his divine purpose was not thwarted by outsiders, but was nearly derailed by his own brothers. Their jealousy and fear were ignited not by Joseph's actions, but by his dreams, dreams that spoke of a future they could not accept. This familial betrayal is a stark reminder that spiritual opposition doesn't always come from faceless enemies, but can come from those we love and trust. The lesson here is profound. It teaches us that our calling and destiny might sometimes threaten those around us, even our families. The path God sets us on can provoke insecurity or hostility in those who are supposed to support us the most. As painful as it may be, understanding this can help us navigate our relationships more wisely. We learn that while family bonds are sacred, they must not be allowed to stifle the divine purpose within us. Thus, while we cherish our family, we must also be prepared to stand firm in our faith and convictions, even if it means facing opposition from unexpected places. Recognizing that sometimes those who know us best might not always have our best interests at heart is crucial for anyone on a spiritual journey marked by a higher calling. Family members may not show resistance until you start to step into your calling. As you begin to walk in alignment with what God has planned for you, those closest to you might struggle with the change. They see you through the lens of the past, not realizing that you are no longer just operating on your own, but are now in partnership with God. This divine collaboration lifts you beyond your origins and points you towards a greater destiny. This internal family conflict isn't just about personal misunderstandings, but is often used by adversarial forces to hinder your spiritual and personal growth. The familiarity and intimacy they have with you can be weaponized. Under the guise of knowing your potential and your limits, they might attempt to keep you within the bounds they find comfortable. However, it's crucial for every chosen individual to recognize these dynamics and not let them stifle or derail their divine path. When faced with such familial opposition, it's vital not to let it silence or crush your spirit. Understanding that such trials are part of being chosen can help you withstand and navigate these challenges without allowing them to destroy you. Recognize the nature of the battle and fortify yourself with faith and resilience, knowing that your journey is about more than where you come from. It's about where God is leading you. Joseph and David are prime examples of individuals who faced immense adversity, not from strangers, but often from those within their own circles, yet did not let these challenges destroy them. They persevered, recognizing the roles such trials played in their divine journey. Similarly, another group to be wary of is the opportunists, often referred to as pretenders. Pretenders integrate into your life not out of genuine care or affection, but because they see an opportunity for themselves. They are with you as long as the circumstances benefit them. When everything is going well, they seem supportive, almost convincingly so. However, their loyalty and support are as fleeting as their presence. The moment you encounter obstacles, or when your situation no longer serves their interests, they disappear. These individuals are not just fair-weather friends, they are strategic about their associations, always scanning for benefits they can extract. Their involvement in your life is calculated based on what they can gain. When the scales tip away from their advantage, they quickly recede into the background, often leaving without a trace. For example, you might find yourself in a thriving partnership with one of these opportunists, and suddenly, without any apparent reason, they withdraw their support or presence. It's as if they vanish when you most need them, because their commitment was never to you, but to the benefits they derived from being associated with you. This pattern of behavior underscores their true nature. They are always on the lookout for the next opportunity, the next person who can serve their agenda. When you reflect on a relationship that has suddenly ended, you might find yourself bewildered, questioning what went wrong. What did I do, you might ask yourself, after realizing that despite your best efforts and the countless ways you've supported someone, they've abruptly disappeared from your life. This departure often leaves a bitter taste, not because of the separation itself, but because it reveals a harsh truth. They were never truly with you. These individuals, whom we can refer to as opportunists, initially come into your life under the guise of friendship or partnership. However, their real motive is to leverage your position, receive resources, or influence to further their own goals. Once they find someone else who can serve their needs better, or once they've extracted what they can from you, their loyalty and presence evaporate. This sudden absence isn't just about them moving on. It's a clear indication that their commitment was conditional, hinged entirely on what they stood to gain. Such relationships can be incredibly draining, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. These opportunists not only consume your energy, but also divert your focus from your true purpose and calling. As they draw on your resources, you may find yourself investing more in their success than in your own, gradually losing sight of your goals and diluting your own strength. It's crucial, especially if you are a person chosen by God, to remain vigilant about these types of individuals. Recognizing them for what they are, users of opportunity rather than genuine companions, can save you much heartache and preserve your energy for those truly worthy of your time and efforts. Be wary of investing in those who show signs of fleeting loyalty and understand that as a person of destiny, such challenges are part of your journey.